Hey guys, so today's makeup tutorial is going to be on this super warm smoky eye that I did with the Morphe 350 palette, and I paired it with some really dark chocolate lips, which are really popular and trendy right now. The 350 palette is super popular, so I wanted to do a look using it. I know it's hard to get your hands on it because it is such a popular palette by them and it's always sold out. I got mine back in October and I'm so happy I did because I literally use it all the time. I know some people are intimidated by these like super orange coppery shades, but don't be. I did use them today to kind of show you how you can make them wearable. I know they are a little intimidating because they are so bright, and I would definitely be careful if you're on the paler side to just use hints of them and not like put it all over your eye, because then you may look like a little sick. It's all about the way you pair the eyeshadows. Like if you're going to do a super orangey crease and you have very light skin, then do neutral shades on the lid. It's all about the way you pair them, and I wanted to do a look focusing on these orangey shades in the palette to kind of show people how to use them, because they can be really beautiful if you use them the right way. So I hope you enjoy the video. If you have any questions or anything like that, leave them down below, and I hope you enjoy. Bye-bye.
Okay guys, so the first thing I'm going to do is prime my eyes. I'm using the Eden Primer Potion by Urban Decay, and this is going to get rid of any discoloration and prep my eyes for the eyeshadow that I will be applying. Once you've blended the primer out, you're then going to want to apply a powder. This is going to just get rid of any tackiness and help the eyeshadows blend a lot better. Now I'm going to apply a soft brown shade into the crease, and I'm going to really blend this out, and this is going to act as our transition shade. That way when we go to add more color, everything looks really blended and has a gradient effect. Then I'm going to apply more of an orange based eyeshadow, and I'm going to focus this more on the lower part of the crease and lid. Now once I blended those two eyeshadows out, I'm going to apply that pretty bright orange shade, and don't be scared, just use a little bit. That's why I put my hands up like that, like literally just use the tiniest bit. It's just getting that little hint of that beautiful bright orange, and you don't want it to overpower your look, but you want it to kind of accent it, if that makes any sense. So now I'm going to deepen everything up, and I'm going to focus that deeper brown in the outer part of my crease and in the lower part of my crease. Each color that I've used, I've gotten lower and lower with it, and that's what adds dimension and depth to the look. You always want to make sure to blend in between every few steps, just to make sure everything's kind of blended and nice and smooth and nothing is super blotchy. Now I'm taking this beautiful copper shade from the palette, and I'm wetting it with Max Fix Plus, and I'm pressing it onto my eyelid. You can see it's super pigmented, and I'm focusing this on the middle to outer part of my eyelid. Thank you. Now I'm deepening everything up even further, and with a smaller brush, I'm just focusing this deeper brown. It's kind of a reddish brown in the very outer corner of my eye. It's all about taking a little bit at a time, and instead of just loading a bunch of products onto your brush, you want to definitely add a little bit at a time, especially with colors like this, because it can get a little messy. Now I'm adding a copper eyeliner by L'Oreal, and I'm putting this in the lower waterline and on the lower lashes as well. There, I was just blending out the eyeliner, and now I'm going to take the color that I just showed in the palette and I'm going to press it onto the lower lash line over the eyeliner. The eyeliner is just going to help the eyeshadow come off more intense. And then I am going to take a deeper brown and focus that more on the outer corner of the eyeliner. On the lower lash line rather, and I'm also going to put that same color on the outer corner of the eyelid. Now I'm taking that bright orange again, and I'm going to use that to blend out my lower lash line. Don't be scared to really blend everything out, especially on the lower lash line. I know some people get a little intimidated by the fact that you're going to have like a super orange lower lash line, but again, if you use a combination of colors and then use a little hint of that orange, then it'll actually be very pretty. Now I'm taking that dark brown and I'm just smudging it on the outer corner of my upper lash line. This is just adding depth, and I'm not going to be using any very dark liquid liner or anything like that. I'm only going to be applying eyelashes, but I did want to give my lashes and lash line a little bit of definition with the dark brown. Now I am applying mascara, and then I'm going to be applying Morphe's 412 false eyelashes, which are really beautiful because they're not overpowering, they're pretty natural, but they still add a little bit of something special to the look. There, I was just showing you that I am wearing a shirt and that I'm not topless. It's just off the shoulders. But anyway, I am going to be using this Wet n Wild contour and highlight disc. I'm using the contour shade, and I'm really using it to bronze up my skin, not necessarily contour. It's a really warm powder. It has a very orange base to it, so I wouldn't recommend using it to contour, because contour shade should usually be on the cooler side and have a very gray base, but I love this powder for bronzing up my skin because it's just the perfect shade for my skin tone. And now I'm going to use a shade from the Anastasia contour kit, and I'm going to use that to deepen up my contour area and just give my face a little bit more definition. Next, I'm actually going to be using a blush from, believe it or not, a Forever 21 blush palette. I actually love this blush palette. The colors are so beautiful and so pigmented. So I used that orangey blush because I feel like it really complemented the look very nicely. And of course, we have to highlight. To me, highlighting just brings life back into my face. It just gives me a nice healthy glow. So I'm using the Physicians Formula highlighter, and I use the lighter side of it, not the bronzy side. And I just put it on the tops of my cheekbones, my nose, and my Cupid's bow. Okay, so I blotted off my chapstick just so my lip liner went on a little bit nicer. And now I'm using the LA Girl Endless Lip Liner in the color Cocoa. And then I'm going to be applying my NYX Cosmetics Lingerie Liquid Lipstick in the color Teddy. It's just basically like a dark brown. It's like a pretty much straight up brown. I know this color can be a little weird to some people, but dark brown lips are very popular right now, and I wouldn't hate them until you try them because they actually can be very flattering on a lot of skin tones. Okay, so that is it for my video. I really hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys.